see right here, I have three of the catapults I made. This catapult is called an elastic catapult, this one's called a mangonel catapult, and this one's called a trebuchet catapult. And we'll be discussing what's similar and different about these three catapults. So, straight off the bat, I can see something, all these catapults have something similar in. That's they all have something on their arms to hold their projectiles, or it will just fall off. Right? And they all have something to stop their arm so it does not go the whole way. In the mangonel's case, it's this bar right here. In the trebuchet's case, it's this upper rod right here. In the elastic catapult's case, it's this bottom bar right here. And all of them seem to be having supports, diagonal supports. Diagonal support, and diagonal support. Now let's talk about the differences. The trebuchet uses a counterweight to pull its arm up, while the counterweight, which is stones in this case, pulls down. In the mangonel's case, it's using ropes. It's using torsion rope, which allows the arm to go up. In the elastic catapults, it uses elasticity to spring its projectile up. And one other thing also is that both of these have to be hooked down. It has to be hooked down, and if I don't hook them down, it tends to spring up. It tends to spring up. While in here it's already springed up, we have to move it down and then it springs up. Of course, it's because it's using elastic, while these things can't stretch. And the mangonel uses twisted rope, torsion rope, which brings the arm forward and upward. So if the rope is not torsion, then the rope seems to angle down with the arm, so it falls down. But as soon as it's stretched enough to pick up the weight of the arm, it springs back up. So in the mangonel's case, it uses twisted rope and torsion. And in the elastic catapult's case, it uses elasticity, which is when any substance stretches and de-stretches or forms back into its original state. So if I leave it, it comes back to its original state. And that's basically about it. And yeah, be sure to give it a big fat thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. And comment down below if you have any questions or suggestions on what we should make next. And be sure to subscribe to my channel if you want to watch my upcoming videos. And as always, thanks for watching.